there are a couple of more conventional ways you can apply. You can apply through like a federal semester program, which I think makes you pay to have an internship that doesn't pay. So I don't recommend doing that.
I was in that program, so.
There's their Maryland internship program, which is run through CAPC, which is also good, and they place you at different offices. John did that. I just applied directly to a couple of delegates and senators in the Maryland Senate and House of Delegates. And I ended up working for my own, or not my own, but a Howard County delegate, which is where I'm from, just because they hadn't found anybody yet. So there are offices which wait till the last minute to find staffers. I have applied in December, and the session started in January, beginning of January, so it can be very last minute. But if you really want the cream of the crop in Maryland, you should apply October, end of September. So start getting your resume ready now. And as far as GAO in DC, USA Jobs. I know it's annoying, and there's a lot of, you know, you feel like you're never gonna get it. You're just putting your application out there and it just goes into cyberspace. But people do look at it if there are openings. Don't apply to positions that have just one opening because they're made for somebody else and it's not you. Apply to positions that have multiple openings, because then they're actually looking for students and interns. And yeah.
That's great advice. I'm sorry. I did. There's just one more program that I would recommend on top of federal semester and the Maryland internship program. My junior English course was called Legislative Writing for Professor Lauterbaugh in the English department. And that, I think, prepared me immensely for not just an internship in the House of Delegates, but really any, I guess, legislative internship you would ever do, because it teaches you to write not a 10-page essay to your professor in political science, but a one-page briefer, all the information you need, letters, all the types of materials that you will be giving to your LA and in your legislative assistant. And in many cases, if you're in the Maryland General Assembly, to your delegate or senator themselves, because they're much smaller offices, so the work you do is often seen as more integral rather than the typical image of a Senate office where there's a lot of people sorting bail. I found Heather because I'm really interested in women's issues and health policy, so when I was looking for delegates and senators to intern with, I stumbled upon her record, which is really impressive, contacted her staff members directly, and submitted my resume.
Just to touch upon federal semester real quick, I mean, you do technically pay to do the internship because you're getting credit for it. But the good thing about that is last semester I took 15 credits, I got 6 credits for my internship, and then I took 3 classes. So it allows you to still graduate on time while you do like an internship that is 2 or 3 days a week. That being said, the federal semester program is awesome because the first semester you take a class in one of 4 areas, so there's health, Homeland Security, Foreign Affairs, and Environmental Science. And then they literally hold your hand, they help you with your resume, they help you with their cover letters. They have an unbelievable resource book in their office that has internships all over the government, not just Capitol Hill, and they help you find them and kind of let you know what you should do. And it's a great resource. I think it's the best program I've been in here.
No, but when you know, Maryland General Assembly is contemplating really sticky issues, like gun laws, you get 5,000 to 10,000 people showing up in Annapolis, demonstrating. You have no idea what's going to happen. And you go to these rallies, and everybody is cheering and booing the committee meetings and whatnot. It's just an electric atmosphere, and everybody's like, "Oh, I'm not going out for lunch today," you know. But it's just like you feel like a family, and so you go through everything. Everything's really exciting. Yeah, I was only in 2 days a week, so I didn't have the 3 or 4 days a week. But it was still exciting just those 2 days a week. And I'd come back here, I'm like, wow, everything's very tame, everything's very slow. So that was really exciting. And working at GAO, as an intern, they actually have you doing substantive work. So I did a lot of referencing, tracing, verifying, writing of a congressional testimony. I got my name placed on the congressional testimony as an author. So I put that on my resume, it's on my LinkedIn profile. You know, official GAO testimony to Congress, and that can open some doors for you too.
All that being said, I actually got really lucky. I worked for Senator Tester from Montana. I'm from New Jersey. I knew nothing about Montana going in. And Senator Tester is a Democrat in Montana. So he got elected because he's just an amazing man. Like, he is one of those people that wants to get to know you and he will remember your name forever. And one day I was sitting in my cubicle and he came and he sat on my desk and he started singing to me. And he was like, tell me you like my voice. And I was like, you have a great voice. And then kind of started making fun of him. And we had that like relationship where he was just another guy. Like, he didn't want to be treated like some, like a higher level person. And everyone in my office was the same way. We were a family. Most people were from the Midwest, but some were from Pennsylvania and New Jersey, so I was able to relate to them as well. So yeah, I mean, there are a lot of people in DC who are standoffish and they think that they're great and they don't want anything to do with you, but then there's experiences like this where Senator Tester knows my name, and I went to Montana this summer and I shot him an email, like, the state is amazing, and he emailed me back, and it's just, it's great.
So Congressman Hoyer's office is a little different. He's a very personable guy. He's just always busy. Like, he's literally either in the district or in the whip office or on the House floor. Like, he's always busy. So getting an actual contact with him is even difficult for his own staff members. But I like to look at it more as I'm doing research for his staff members, which are advising the Democratic Party. So for me, I think the most rewarding part was when they asked me to stay on so I could do actual research for them. Because I kind of, over the summer, was doing like the grunt intern work where you're answering phone calls, talking to constituents. And granted, he came around one day and like thanked all the interns and sat down with all of us and met us. But I've kind of realized that getting actual FaceTime with him is not out of the picture, but it's obviously, when he's such a busy person, it's not going to be his priority just because he doesn't have the time. But for me, networking within his researchers and advisors is great. And like I said, I was talking to our research fellow from Brookings yesterday, and he just sat down with me for 2 hours looking at my resume and going through like places for me to apply to. So really networking outside of the congressman and realizing you have a full like set of resources within his office and staff is great.
I think my favorite part was probably the respect you start to get within the office, especially from your legislative aide and chief of staff. The more that you start to work there, the more they begin to lean on you. I know at one point in time, we had 3 or 4 bills that we were trying to get passed through, and they pretty much said, okay, you're going to handle all of the scholarship stuff, and we're going to handle everything else. And it was just like, any time that someone called about scholarship or something, you know, they referred to me, and that's something that became very big for me. It's like, you know, I'm helping the office out by handling this, even though it's maybe a small part of the office. You know, they don't have to worry about that. I'm taking care of that. That was something that was very big for me.